Hello learners, welcome in the National Institute of Open Schooling. Today we will discuss on quadratic equation. We have Dr. Rajpal Singh who will elaborate his ideas on quadratic equation. Namaskar sir.
Thank you Neeraj ji. In our previous program, we have discussed about quadratic polynomial, its zeros, a quadratic equation, its roots. And we have also discussed the method of solving a quadratic equation using the method of factorization. But in so many of the cases, it is not an easy one to factorize a polynomial. Sometimes it becomes very difficult, and in that case, we need some more method, some different method using which we can solve a quadratic equation easily. Today, we will understand one more method to solve a quadratic equation in which we are facing a difficulty in factorization of a quadratic polynomial. Let us see one quadratic equation. It is x square plus x minus 1 equal to 0. In this quadratic equation, we have to factorize this quadratic polynomial x square plus x minus 1. And for factorization of a quadratic polynomial, you know, we have to split the middle term, and splitting should be done in such a way that two splitted parts, their product should be equal to minus 1 and sum should be equal to 1. Now, we are not able to find out two such numbers whose sum is 1 and product is minus 1. So easily. That's what the method of factorization, it becomes difficult to use it here. Now, we will understand a different method to solve such equations. See, what we were doing in method of factorization, we were converting a quadratic polynomial into a product of two linear polynomials. Means, our purpose was to convert a quadratic into a linear one. So, in the same line of thinking, can we think of any different method in which a quadratic can be converted into a linear one? If we take square root of a quadratic one, think of what we will get. When a perfect square is there and we take a square root of a perfect square, you know, we get a linear polynomial. So, we will go on this line of treatment of a question. When in this quadratic equation x square plus x minus 1 equal to 0, we transfer 1 on right hand side, we get the equation as x square plus x equal to 1. And now, for converting quadratic into a linear one, we will make a perfect square of the polynomial which is appearing on the left hand side, means x square plus x. For making a perfect square of x square plus x, we are able to express in this way x square plus x, then we find out what is the coefficient of x. Here we find it is 1. We divide this coefficient by 2, we get 1 by 2, and square of 1 by 2 is added on both of the side of this equation. And we get the equation x square plus 2 into 1 by 2 x plus 1 upon 2 square equal to 1 plus 1 upon 2 square means 1 upon 4. Now we see the left hand side of this equation, it is a perfect square of x plus 1 upon 2. When we have made a perfect square of left hand side, we get the equation as x plus 1 upon 2 whole square equal to 1 plus 1 upon 4 means 5 upon 4. And when we take square root of both of the sides of the equation, we get it equation as x plus 1 upon 2 equal to plus minus under root 5 upon 2. And when we transfer this 1 upon 2 to the right hand side of the equation, we get x equal to minus 1 upon 2 plus minus root 5 upon 2. In this way, we get two different values of x as minus 1 upon 2 plus root 5 upon 2 and minus 1 upon 2 minus root 5 upon 2. In this way, we get an easy method when we are not able to factorize a quadratic polynomial to find out the value of x. Let us take one more example by which it's a different one, because the method which we have used in making it a perfect square, we should see whether it will be a perfect one for all type of quadratic polynomials. This is 3x square minus 5x plus 2 equal to 0. Now, we are making a perfect square in a bit different way. This is 3x square, and if I have to convert this 3x square into a perfect square, in that case this 3 should be 9. So whole of this equation is multiplied by 3 and we get 9x square minus 15x plus 6 equal to 0. Now 9x square is expressed as whole square of 3x minus 2 into 5 upon 2 into 3x plus 6 equal to 0. Now we make a perfect square of these two. 3x whole square minus 2 into 3x into 5 by 2 plus 5 by 2 whole square equal to 5 by 2 whole square minus 6. Now left hand side is converted into a perfect square, and this is whole square of 3x minus 5 upon 2, and right hand side it is 25 upon 4 minus 6. When we simplify right hand side, we get 1 upon 4, which is equal to left hand side as 3x minus 5 by 2 whole square. And when we take square root of both of the sides of this equation, we get it as 3x minus 5 upon 2 equal to plus minus 1 upon 2, and 3x equal to minus 5 upon 2 is transferred to right hand side, we get as 3x equal to 5 upon 2 plus minus 1 upon 2. So value of 3x is equal to 5 upon 2 plus 1 upon 2, or 3x equal to 5 upon 2 minus 1 upon 2. And values of x we get as 3x equal to 3 or 3x equal to 2. So finally, the value of x or the solution of equation is x equal to 1 or x equal to 2 upon 3. We have solved this quadratic equation 3x square minus 5x plus 2 equal to 0 by making this equation as a perfect square. If you see how we have made it a perfect square, the first term, which was 3x square, we have made that a perfect square multiplying that by 3, and it became 9x square, and then we had written it 3x whole square. Now we will understand one more method to make perfect square of a quadratic polynomial. We will use the same equation. The equation is 3x square minus 5x plus 2 equal to 0. In this process, we make the coefficient of x square as 1, and for making it 1, we divide whole of the equation by 3, and equation converts into x square minus 5 upon 3 x plus 2 upon 3 equal to 0. Now the constant term 2 upon 3 is transferred to right hand side, and equation now it is x square minus 5 upon 3 x equal to minus 2 upon 3. Now for making it a perfect square, we divide the coefficient of x by 2. The coefficient is 5 upon 3. When we divide it by 2, we get 5 upon 6, and square of this means square of 5 upon 6 is added to both of the sides of the equation, and equation becomes x square minus 5 upon 3x plus 5 upon 6 whole square equal to minus 2 upon 3 plus 5 upon 6 whole square. When we simplify this, we get x minus 5 whole square. As you see, the left hand side is a perfect square now. This is x minus 5 upon 6 whole square equal to minus 2 upon 3, and square of 5 upon 6 is 25 upon 36. By taking LCM in right hand side, we get it as x minus 5 upon 6 whole square equal to minus 24 plus 25 upon 36, and equation turns into x minus 5 upon 6 whole square equal to 1 upon 36. Now we take square root of both of the sides, we get it as x minus 5 upon 6 equal to plus minus 1 upon 6. For getting the value of x, we transfer this minus 5 upon 6 to right hand side, and values of x we get in this way: x equal to 5 upon 6 plus 1 upon 6, or x equal to 5 upon 6 minus 1 upon 6. Finally, value of x are x equal to 1 or x equal to 2 upon 3. In this way, we make perfect square of a quadratic polynomial either dividing by the coefficient of x square or by making the term involving x square as a perfect square, and then by taking square root we convert it into a linear polynomial. When we get it as a linear polynomial, we know how to solve a linear equation and we get value of x finally.
Sir, can we generalize this method on solving quadratic equation?
Yes, we can generalize this method, and we know a general quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. When in the same way we make a perfect square of this quadratic equation, we divide whole of this equation by a. The equation is x square plus b upon a x plus c upon a equal to 0. And in the same way, we transfer the coefficient term c upon a to the right hand side, and equation turns into x square plus b upon a x equal to minus c upon a. Now we make a perfect square of left hand side. Coefficient of x is b upon a. When we divide it by 2, we get b upon 2a, and square of b upon 2a is added to both of the sides of the equation, and equation becomes x square plus b upon a x plus b upon 2a whole square equal to minus c upon a plus b upon 2a whole square. Now we simplify the right hand side and we get x plus b upon 2a whole square equal to minus c upon a plus b square upon 4a square. On further simplification of right hand side, by taking LCM, equation converts into x plus 2a whole square equal to minus 4ac plus b square. The whole is divided by 4a square. Now, when left hand side has become a perfect square, we take under root of both of the sides of the equation, and equation is x plus b upon 2a equal to plus minus under root b square minus 4ac. The whole is divided by 2a. And when the constant term of left hand side b upon 2a is transferred to right hand side, we get the value of x equal to minus b upon 2a plus minus under root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Now we see the denominator of both of these fractions is 2a, and when we simplify further, we get x equal to minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. In this particular generalized formula, we denote this b square minus 4ac by d, which we say this is discriminant of this equation, and value of x we get as minus b plus minus under root d upon 2a. Now, using this particular formula, what we have made for general quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, let us solve one of the quadratic equation using this particular formula. The equation is 4x square plus 4 under root 3x plus 3 equal to 0. Here, if we compare this equation with a general quadratic equation, we get the values of a, b and c as a equal to 4, b equal to 4 under root 3 and c equal to 3. Now, first we calculate the value of discriminant, which is d equal to b square minus 4ac. We put the values of b, a and c, and d is equal to 4 under root 3 whole square minus 4 into 4 into 3. On further simplification, we get it as d equal to under root 48 minus 48, and value of d is equal to 0. Now we put these particular values of d, a in value of x. X equal to minus 4 under root 3 means minus b plus minus under root d. On the place of d we put 0. The whole is divided by 2a means 2 into 4. And we get the value of x as minus root 3 upon 2. Keep in mind, in such problems where we get value of d as 0, these equations are already a perfect square. We are not needed to convert them into a perfect square if we are solving the equation by process of making a perfect square. Then these equations turns into a perfect square already and we can solve them. Let us take one more equation. This is x square plus 7x minus 60 equal to 0. We find the values of a, b and c by comparison as a equal to 1, b equal to 7 and c equal to minus 60. The value of d becomes b square minus 4ac, means it is 7 square minus 4 into 1 into minus 60, and d is equal to 49 plus 240 as 289. When we use these values, we get x equal to minus 7 plus minus under root 289 upon 2 into 1. We know the square root of 289 is 17, and we get x equal to minus 7 plus minus 17 upon 2. The two values of x we get as x equal to minus 7 plus 17 upon 2 and x equal to minus 7 minus 17 upon 2, and two different values for x are 5. X equal to 5 and x equal to minus 12. The equations which are not solvable easily using the method of factorization, and we use method of making a perfect square without following the whole procedure, we can use this direct formula, means x equal to minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac, and whole is divided by 2a.
Sir, what is importance of discriminant in studying quadratic equation?
Yes, discriminant gives us very important informations about the roots or say solutions of a quadratic equation. When we find values of d, we have in total three possibilities. Either it will be equal to 0, it will be greater than 0, or it could be less than 0. The very first case, when value of d means b square minus 4ac, it is equal to 0. The very first case, when we get the value of d means b square minus 4ac as greater than 0, it indicates that the equation will have a real and distinct roots, means two different real numbers will be there for value of x. In second case, when we find that value of d is equal to 0, in that case there will be two roots, but both of these roots will be having the same value. So we can say they are real and repeated roots, or say real and the same root. In third case, when value of d, or say b square minus 4ac, is less than 0, in that case the value of d is negative, and when we take the square root of a negative 1, it turns into an imaginary number, and in that case the roots of quadratic equation are imaginary.
I hope you have enjoyed the program. You will be able to solve the problems using quadratic equation. Thank you, learner. Thank you, sir. Namaskar.
Thank you very much.
हिंदुस्तान के हर कोने में नौजवानों के पास प्रतिभा है, उन्हें अवसर चाहिए।
NIOS देता रहा है युवाओं को अवसर आगे बढ़ने का। NIOS से पढ़ने वाले इन युवाओं ने किया है संस्थान को गौरवान्वित। दिव्यांगों ने बनके दिखाया है सबल और आत्मनिर्भर NIOS के साथ। आप भी जुड़िए NIOS के संग।
Welcome to the National Institute of Open Schooling, Reaching the Unreached. Popularly known as NIOS, it is the largest open schooling system in the world, offering courses in multiple subjects and multiple languages. NIOS lit the lamp of knowledge 25 years ago, and 25 years of excellence lit up the lives of 2.52 million people. Confident smiles, empowered smiles, smiles of living a life of dignity and pride. 18 regional centers were also established during this period. NIOS caters mostly to the education of the disadvantaged who missed their first chance of education due to varied socio-economic reasons. For children like these, education was only a distant dream, but NIOS made their dream of a better tomorrow come true.
The NIOS with 2.2 million students is clearly the largest open school in the world. If there were no NIOS, where would the 892,578 students gone? So, I mean, look at them not as a statistic, but as people with faces who would have no other way, place to go to.
Firmly believing in the dictum that quality education is the birthright of all, NIOS is open to one and all, irrespective of caste, creed, color, or religion. Add flexibility to it, and you have the successful dream model. Flexibility in the choice of subjects, in the place of study, in the medium of instruction, in sitting for your exams. In fact, NIOS conducts two full-fledged board exams per year. Another unique facility NIOS offers is an on-demand examination, wherein you appear for your exam as per your convenience and preparation. All you have to do is register for it. Living up to its motto, education anytime, anywhere, and for anyone, NIOS ensures that social backgrounds have no relevance. Able and differently enabled have an equally bright future, and age is meaningless.
I am going to talk about a lady. She is about 88 years old. She met me recently. She has written a book, name of the book, Bride at 10, Mother at 15, MA at 80. With all the family's commitment, she was proud to announce everywhere that she is appearing for a MA degree at the age of 78 through distant education at Delhi Center.
But NIOS also realized that just quality education was not enough. Getting trained in vocational skills was equally important. And so, vocational training became a part of the curriculum, thereby linking education with livelihood. Today, we have 86 vocational courses, but that is only half the story. To ensure that our students have a more promising future, we are collaborating with prestigious organizations like NSDC, ITDC, Cisco, IMA, CIDC, etc. Under the Sakshar Bharat program of Government of India, between 2010 and March 2013, NIOS has assessed more than 3 crore neo-literates and certified about 2.5 crore by giving due recognition to their literacy skills. The innovational horizon of NIOS is also dotted with sports stars, film stars, singers, violinists, painters, beauticians, plumbers, etc. But there was no magical wand or Aladdin's chirag that created this incredible institution. It was the sheer hard work and vision of dedicated, committed, and progressive educationists. Extensive use of modern technology is evident everywhere. Study material is prepared in self-learning mode. State-of-the-art studios produce audiovisual and multimedia programs that supplement the study material. The Learning Support Center connects with students online and helps them with their problems. Web radio broadcasts quality educational programs daily. This unique model has now been adopted by many of the Commonwealth countries. In November 2009, the Commonwealth Open Schooling Association, or COMOSA, was launched. Dr. S.S. Jenner, chairman of NIOS, was elected as the founding chairman of COMOSA, confirming its leadership in open schooling system in the world. But the story of NIOS doesn't stop here.